Welcome to New Hampshire's WildSide. I'm Christina Loopy.
And I'm Mark Beauchesne. We'll take you behind the scenes of the New Hampshire Fish and Game Department to learn more about the projects and people of your wildlife agency.
We'll also give you tips and tactics to help you make the most of your time in New Hampshire's woods and waters.
And along the way, we'll meet real people who love life outdoors.
Now, let's discover more about New Hampshire's WildSide.
Hopefully we can bring some insight on some catfish in here in the Connecticut River. This is, honestly, this is enjoyable. This is a lot of fun.
A lot less work than bass fishing.
It's an underutilized resource. A lot of the river is. Some people don't want to go away from their normal places, but they got to come out here and check this out. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Any place you get a major river coming in, that's where you're going to catch most of your cats anyways. There's a lot of food coming into that area. Catfish are going to eat anything they can get their mouths around. They're not just a bottom feeder. Everybody thinks catfish being a bottom feeder. Channel cats are apex predators. They eat shad, they eat shiners, they eat perch, they eat bass, they eat whatever they can grab.
Dead or alive.
Yeah, dead or alive. And that's why they're gonna be the apex predator next to pike in this river. The place we're gonna go up to, it's a confluence of where the Ashuelet comes in. The bottom there, we're only in what, 6 or 7 feet of water. It's real, it's got a lot of the dunes in it, a lot of eelgrass, and the fish will just swim through there and grab in small bait fish and the fish that will die and get hung up in the grass. So we're not in tremendously deep water in the evening. They're coming into these shallow spots. It's easier to anchor and you don't have to cast very far. These fish, they're not picky. They're gonna come in and sometimes they'll swim right to the boat. What we use is a slip rig where you just tie on a snap swivel on your main line, and then you have half ounce, quarter ounce, whatever the river's calling for. I usually use a half ounce regardless. It holds. Catfish aren't real picky on what they're biting. And we use a 5-aught circle hook. It helps us to release the fish a lot more efficiently. And we run all pretty much medium to medium heavy rods. Basically, basic bass tackle is what we use. We use bells at night, you know, or light up pieces on the end of the rod so you can see or hear when you get a strike. I'm not even really in a big rush to get them out until the sky's black. But I mean, you put them out now, we can move, we'll put some out, and we'll probably catch some big fall fish first. That's generally the norm. Once the fall fish stop biting, you know the cats are moving in, because they don't want to be anywhere near these guys because they get eaten.
It's all new to me. I'm excited about
it. It won't be your first time after this.
No.
I'm never happier when I get chicken liver on my fingers.
This is already exciting.
Yeah.
You know, you're in the line, you're on the line. You know the bell's there. And that anticipation is awesome. Great place to shoot.
There we go. All right, we have lunch. This time of year doesn't get much better than this. Oh, you got one. Nice.
Might be a cat, I don't know. And we're in the boat. Yeah. There's our channel cat. First one of the night, about 16. Oh yeah.
We want to flip the lights on.
Yep.
Courtesy light, yep.
It's an eel.
That's a decent one.
If he's too deep, I'm just gonna cut him.
Yep.
They're such awesome animals. Yeah, that's definitely
terrible. Yeah, just cut it.
See you later, bud.
Thank you.
Well, get that. drag's not set on that. Oh, that's a good one. That's a four.
Yeehaw!
Nice job, Woo! Mark.
Congratulations.
That's what happens, you kids are good.
They're not all stories.
Oh, I got two. Yeah. I got two.
Doubles.
That one's a good one there, too. Unless I've got your line, I don't know where. How's that? That's a good one.
What'd I say? When the water starts flowing, we catch fish. All right, got one out.
All right. Hear that? Good. Nice, clean, beautiful fish.
Oh, that's a decent one.
Oh, that is a good one. Okay, this one's going back. Unless you want to eat another eater?
One more.
All right.
Yep, one more. Well, I'm all good. That's a good looking fish.
That's a beauty.
This is a nice.
That's a gorgeous fish.
Yeah.
Hey. Jim, this is awesome. Catfishing in New Hampshire? Who knew? Yeah. Now I do.
Yeah. You don't have to go down south to catch them.
Holy moly, what a beautiful fish, too. Thank you.
Yeah, this got hit a couple of times there. Yeah, I've been baited.
That one's got a little bit of a shoulder to him.
What'd you want?
Beautiful fish. All right, buddy. You're gonna go back and make some more baby catfish for us. What a beauty. Yeah, it's got the spot, the beautiful spots on it. It's a younger fish. As they get older, they lose them. I love it.
They're smooth, smooth fish.
To me, they're the most beautiful fish in the river. I heard a wiggle.
Got one. It? Yep.
Jim's on.
Oh, lost him.
Heard nothing.
Lost him. Can't catch them all.
With over 975 lakes and ponds to play on, it's better outside because we're here connecting you to life outdoors. Now watch this. Thank you.
There are 365 days in a year. New Hampshire Fishing Game's 6 hatcheries are open all of them, raising fish that will become part of your next outdoor adventure.
Hey, we're out on Great Bay, kayak fishing for striped bass today. And we've got the sit-on-top angling kayak here, specifically designed for fishing for stability and space. A couple of really important things when you head out on your kayak, especially in tidal waters, is a good PFD. Make sure you wear that at all times. A couple other essentials are a leash on your paddle. If the fishing gets really crazy and exciting, you may want to make sure that that paddle's tied off just in case you drop it in the water. You don't want it to float away on you. Kind of useless then. So let's go catch some fish. What we look for a lot of times is birds. Where there's birds, there's bait. And when there's bait, there's usually stripers. They'll work the bait to the surface and then they'll ambush them on the surface. On days like today, when you're doing a lot of paddling and great distances, you really want to make sure that your paddling form is as good as you can get it. You want to paddle a lot with your torso and not so much with your arms and shoulders, because you'll wear yourself out. So I'm just twitching a soft plastic right now, something that'll stay kind of close to the surface and look like these bait fish that they're after. Fish on. Not a very big fish. Oh, he got a back on him. Little guy. One thing I really like about this Wi-Fi enabled fish finder is that when I'm guiding clients, anybody with an iPhone or an Android phone can download the free app and they can connect to the same transducer, so everybody that's in the kayak can see what's down there for fish. This is a better fish. This is when it really helps to have this leash on the paddle, because if this gets knocked off, I can just continue to fight this fish and not have to worry about that paddle. The thing with the kayak especially is you want to wear these fish out before you get them to the side of the boat. Get them tired out so they're not splashing too much. Yeah, that's a better fish. Nice Great Bay striped bass.
Use the hashtag #BetterOutside when you share your videos or photos showing how you connect to life outdoors. And be sure to tag New Hampshire Fishing Game on Facebook and Instagram.
Thanks for watching. To learn more about life outdoors and New Hampshire Fishing Game, check out these videos and subscribe.